In this video, you'll learn how to make your voice sound better for video for free. Taking your audio from this to this for free. I'm Andrew Can, and if I can, you can too. When it comes to video, audio is 50% of the experience. Using Premiere Rush, you'll learn how to make your voice sound better in video for free. If you want to learn more filmmaking tips around audio and video, subscribe and ring that bell to overcome hurdles such as audio. When people start creating videos, they might record just into the camera, maybe use an external mic, or maybe for more professionals, use a boom mic into a professional recorder. However, you might not be sure how to edit the audio once you record it. I know I was when I first started, but I'm going to show you Premiere Rush's advanced audio panel and how easy it makes it to make your voice sound better for free. To get started, you'll need to download Premiere Rush, which is a free video editor. Those of you with a Creative Cloud subscription might have Premiere Rush included in your package. If you don't have Premiere Rush, you can download it for free by using my affiliate link in the description. You can also install Premiere Rush on either your Android or iOS device, so stick around until the end of this video to learn how you can edit audio and video using Premiere Rush on your mobile device. In Premiere Rush, you can edit pre-recorded audio clips or record your own voiceovers to clips. We're going to use pre-recorded clips, so to get started, you'll name your project here, and then select the clip you wish to use. Once your clip is loaded in, let's expand the editing track by clicking this icon in the bottom left-hand corner. I like expanding the tracks because it lets me see more of my video editing timeline. After that, we'll select this blue plus in the top left-hand corner and select VoiceOver. To start recording your own voiceover, this red button will appear on your timeline. Wherever your playhead is located is where your voiceover starts recording. Premiere Rush then gives you a 3-second countdown until you can record. Premiere Rush will then add your voiceover to an empty audio track for you, so you don't have to worry about recording over existing audio. It's important to note that editing your audio can only get you so far. How close your recording device is to your subject, using a high-quality microphone, finding a good room to record in, or even one that's acoustically treatment will get you better results. I'll let you listen to a clip that I recorded using my Panasonic G7 and a Rode video mic with no audio editing. This is what my voice sounds like in my living room. You can hear that there is some echo in my clip, and that I'm competing with my AC unit. We're going to select Control 5 on Windows, or Command 5 if you're on a Mac, to open up the audio panel. You can also just select the audio icon on the right-hand side. Inside the audio editing options, you'll see three different selections: Basic, Advanced, and Channels. Basic lets you control the volume of the audio or mute the audio track if you'd like. You can raise the volume by moving this slider. If you wish to reset the volume to defaults, all you have to do is double-click on this point. Next is Advanced, but before we look at Advanced, go ahead and select Channels. This will let you see your left and right audio channels. If you select one of them, it will mute that audio channel. You'll want the channel selected, so when you're making changes to the audio, you can see those changes. That said, let's look at the Advanced Audio settings. Premiere Rush will automatically detect what type of audio it's found. In our case, it's noted that the audio was a human voice. However, you can change this either to music or other. One of my favorite things is, if you hover over some of these options, you can see previews from Adobe about what each section does. As you can see, auto volume applies to your entire project to keep the audio level. You may also notice it's affected our channel section. I'll make the selection here, and it will change the audio levels. Balanced sound raises the volume on the lower sounds and lowers the higher sounds. This is helpful if multiple people are talking at different volume levels and you want them to be balanced. Reduce background noise removes steady background noises that might be distracting, things like a fridge hum, cars passing by, or even talking in the distance. Reduce echo helps reduce the echo, sound reflection, and reverb in the audio. Finally, Premiere Rush has presets to make either male or female voices sound better. A combination of all of these effects can really make your voice sound better. I love that Adobe includes these useful animation reminders when you hover over an effect so you can see what it does. Since every clip is different, you need to be able to identify what your clip needs when it comes to audio editing. When it comes to editing audio, you'll want a good pair of headphones. So put on your good pair of headphones and let's get started editing these clips. I usually select auto volume and balanced sound. However, this is where your own personal preference comes in. Everyone's different, and do what you believe to sound the best. Since I know there is background noise in my clip, I'll select Reduce Background Noise, but if you don't have noticeable background noise, you can leave it alone. In my case, I know there's the hum of my AC unit, so I want to remove that and set the intensity slider a little higher than standard. Again, experiment to what you think sounds best. Next, I'll select Reduce Echo. I know that there's a good amount of echo in the room I recorded this in, but every room has a slight echo, so I'll lower this while keeping the effect on. Then I select Enhance Speech. I'll choose the male preset since I have more bass in my voice. However, if you have a higher pitch voice, the female preset might make more sense, but use what works best for your voice. Everything you've done on the computer can be done as easily on your mobile device. So let's load up Rush on our phones and start editing on the go. In the mobile app, if you've loaded a clip on the computer into Rush and want to edit the sound on the go, Rush will be able to cloud store it up to 2 GB on the free version, so you can continue to edit that clip from your computer on your mobile phone. All changes you make on your phone will also save to your computer. Just make sure when you're editing audio that you have a high-quality pair of headphones. Just like the desktop, all of the audio properties are there when you're editing on your mobile device. Now that we've edited our clip, let's move on to the sound test. This is what my voice sounds like in my living room. This is what my voice sounds like in my living room. If you're happy with your edited audio, select Share here. Then, choose where you want to publish your video. I'll render the video locally, and then select the folder I wish to render the video to. Let's look at the quality options. I recorded my video at 4K resolution at 24 frames per second, so I'll select Advanced. You'll see a dropdown. Click it, and select the video quality that's right for your recorded video. For me, it's YouTube 4K. Once you're happy with your video settings, let it render and you are ready to share out your video. It's important to note that free Premiere Rush users will only get 3 rendered out videos, but you can practice and test as many projects as you'd like. That's how easy it is to make your voice sound better for free. There are some limits on the free version, but it's an amazing software to use. If you'd like to see Premiere Pro's version of this, subscribe and ring that bell to be notified for when that video drops. Again, audio is half the battle, so having a tool like this is powerful. Remember, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can, you can too.